$2,000 New Year's Day stimulus check. We'll be talking through all the details in this video, so let's get into it right now. But if you haven't done so yet, or if you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button right down below the video so I can keep you updated each and every day with all of this information that continues changing very rapidly, especially as we work our way through all of these multi-trillion dollar packages, proposals, amendments, reform, announcements, and anything else that may be coming out that we might not even recognize quite yet. So again, thank you so much for joining me. My dedication to you and this community as a whole is number one, to be here for you every single day with all the latest updates and to also help you get as much money, benefits, and anything else we can possibly get our hands on right now during this very tough time. So again, thank you so much for joining. Hit that subscribe button right down below the video if you haven't done so yet. And let's get into this right now. But first off, hey, Happy New Year's. Great to have you here joining with me once again. Wow, where did 2021 go? What a weird time, seriously. I don't know about you, but I feel like I almost fell asleep and all of a sudden I woke up and 2021 was gone. I mean, seriously, that year, I don't know about you, but for me, it seemed like it just zipped right on by. And here we are already in the new year. And we've already been living through this COVID thing in year number three, 2020, 21, and now 2022. So unbelievable how time is going so fast. And here we are yet again, and things are zipping right on by. So I hope the year is going well for you already, considering we've only been into it for what, a few hours now? Not even 24 hours quite yet. But anyway, I hope the year is going well for you. And thank you so much for being part of this community. We're gonna do anything we possibly can to make this year even better for everybody right here in this community. We're gonna do some really big things here this year. I don't know about you, but we're kind of sick and tired of waiting for Congress to act. Therefore, I'm gonna really step up this year and do anything we possibly can to make sure that everybody in this community is really living a better life, because honestly, it's getting tough out there. And honestly, we are getting sick and tired of waiting for Congress to do something to help all of us out. Therefore, I have some pretty cool ideas, some creative ideas. I'm going to kind of run by you here in the next couple days, couple weeks here. I'm going to run a few things by you and see what we can do to work together this year to make sure that all of us are living a much better life where we're not struggling so much, right? I mean, let's just be real. That's kind of what's happening to a lot of people, and it is not fair. So, one quick question before we get into this. Do you have any New Year's resolutions for this year? Again, you don't need to leave those down below in the comment section. If you want to, feel free to do so, but I know that's kind of a private thing. I'm not asking you to share with me. I'm just simply asking, do you have New Year's resolutions for the new year here? I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm not really a New Year's resolution type of person. I'm more of the kind of person that throughout the year, if I wanna make any changes or if I wanna improve on something, if I wanna implement something or whatever, I usually just start it right away. However, don't get me wrong, I do think that New Year's and starting the calendar over and just starting out fresh right in January, I do think it's kind of cool, right? It's a little bit motivating. It's kind of a fun time to just start fresh, just turn over a new leaf and just kind of, you know, start everything all over and just kind of just start off on a new foot, right? So I do think it's kind of a fun time of year where you can just kind of start fresh and feel like, okay, here I am. I'm energized. I'm motivated once again. Let's get some things done here and get going with it. So I think it's kind of a fun time. But anyway, just kind of curious if anybody has some New Year's resolutions or, you know, what you're planning on going forward. Again, if you don't, that's totally fine. Like I said, I just told you a second ago, I'm not really a New Year's resolution type of person anyway. So if you do, I'm, you know, happy for you. And if there's anything I can do to help you achieve whatever it is, please let me know. I want to do whatever I can to help people in this community, of course, within reason. You know, I'm not going to go like jump out of a plane or something. Not into that, but I always want to do whatever I can to help people in this community. So again, thanks so much for joining me again in a new year. It's awesome to have you here. Let's get into this and talk about a $2,000 New Year's Day stimulus check and what's going on with this. Where is this all coming from? What is happening? And what's Congress doing? Are they just sleeping or what's going on with them? They probably are sleeping, honestly, considering they were probably all out late last night, probably early into the morning. Let's be real, they're probably all still sleeping. just being honest. So I have no clue what they're doing. Just saying, they're probably doing that. All right, let's talk about this. So when it comes to a $2,000 New Year's Day stimulus check, leading up to this, it was just like many of these other holiday stimulus checks that we've been seeing. The $2,000 Thanksgiving Day stimulus check about a month and a half ago, the $2,000 Christmas Day stimulus check, you know, a week ago or whatever, 2 weeks ago, a couple weeks ago, and now this one, the $2,000 New Year's Day stimulus check. So essentially, it all comes down to the exact same thing, which is these big movements between people, groups, advocacy groups, all kinds of things out on social media, articles, headlines, all kinds of different things popping up, talking about a $2,000 New Year's Day stimulus check. Essentially, it's a bunch of people getting behind this big movement, trying to urge Congress, trying to gain some support, some ideas, just trying to get a bunch of attention on a $2,000 stimulus check, which happens to be called the $2,000 New Year's Day stimulus check. Now, this is actually a great thing because, as we've talked about so many times, the more attention that we can get on something, the more people that we can have backing up a movement, the more people that you can have kind of signing on a petition or signing into an idea, the higher the likelihood of something actually happening and it actually getting attention. So now that we're actually into the new year and Congress will be returning very soon here from their long holiday break. Yeah, hope they enjoyed it. Thank you so much, everybody. Yeah, right? Sure would have been nice if they stayed through the holidays like they talked about back in early December. They said, yeah, we're going to work our way right on through the holidays. Yeah, right. We knew that they wouldn't. Of course, they jumped on their planes and they, you know, flew back home and do whatever they do. Sure would have been nice if they stuck it out through the holidays and worked like they said they were going to. But anyway, so they'll be back in session here sometime soon. And of course, the landscape has changed significantly since they actually left on their vacation, right? So especially with this whole COVID situation, inflation through the roof on fire, white hot inflation, some things have changed quite a bit. So maybe when they come back from this, and also just about, what was it? Maybe a week and a half, maybe 2 weeks ago now, I did see some circling information talking about a couple of representatives coming out, talking about this new idea of introducing a new COVID relief bill, otherwise known as a stimulus package. So now that things have changed so dramatically since they left on their vacation, by the time that they return here in a couple days, they may just be actually thinking about something like a new approach to this whole situation, right? As we've been talking about here over the last couple days, we're having record COVID surges across numerous different states. We're having record COVID cases across the entire country, 500,000 or more every single day, right? There's a lot of stuff going on. So, I mean, we're seeing some massive, massive spikes here. We're also seeing voluntary closures, voluntary cancellations of multiple different things going on across multiple different industries, sporting events, concerts, different gatherings, things like this. Even airlines canceling thousands upon thousands of flights. Over the last, 9 days from now, we've seen thousands of flights canceled, over 7,000 flights just in the last, 7 or 8 days, we've seen 7,000 plus flights canceled. That's a massive closure. Think of the economic impact that has. Just those flights alone. What if it continues at the same rate that it is? So the point is, maybe now that Congress will be back, maybe they're going to change their tune a little bit, possibly pivot away from the Build Back Better agenda, which again, we've talked about that many times. That is the stimulus package that at this point doesn't contain a whole lot for the people. Yes, it does contain the child tax credit payments, an extension for 1 year in there. There's a little bit of money in there for Section 8 and housing for low-income individuals. Other than that, there's about $150 billion in there for in-home care for seniors and people with disabilities. Other than that, there's not a whole lot in the package, right? We've talked about that, and we've tried to do anything that we possibly can to get Congress to add an additional stimulus check into that package, which, by the way, they could easily do at any given point. They could add a stimulus check into that package. There's no rule or provision saying they cannot add one in there. They absolutely can. It would just be a matter of writing up a page, half of a page of legislation. It would not take them very much to do, and it would only take somebody maybe 5-6 minutes to write up the legislation. It would not take much at all for them to type it up and add it right into the bill. And we already know that there's about $500 billion sitting on the books right now that has not been spent according to the reports that we've been seeing and we've talked about a couple times in previous videos. So the whole point is, Now that Congress is back, now that we've turned the leaf on a new page, the landscape has changed with the whole COVID situation, inflation is running hot, we've got a package on the table, we have representatives possibly talking about another COVID relief bill, otherwise known as a stimulus package. There's a lot of things that have changed since they actually departed on their vacation. So, now that they may rejoin us here, we might actually see some additional action out of Congress, considering some of those people were talking about that other stimulus package. Maybe they're going to talk about this and say, hey, you know, we have to do something for the people. There's actually been some speculation as well. I'm going to be honest with you. I've only seen this in a couple locations. I haven't been able to see this or actually cross-reference this as I usually like to do, cross-reference my information just to make sure that everything is accurate that I'm bringing you. I've only seen this in a couple locations here, like two sources, which again, I don't know. I haven't really felt that great about it, but apparently Ron Wyden, who again is one of the very powerful senators, a very influential advocate, senator, he has also, there's been speculation that he might be bringing an introduction for the outline of a new stimulus package here sometime soon that'll actually be focused more on the American people. Again, I haven't seen anything as far as an outline. All I've heard is that speculation of Ron Wyden possibly bringing this new plan. Again, not even sure if it's going to happen, but that's just what I've heard in a couple different sources here, and we'll see if that actually happens or not. But according to what there's been saying about this, this plan or this bill for this new other package that, again, I don't even know what it's being called, but this is just what's been said out there as far as what Ron Wyden may be bringing, could be a package more focused on the American people. So again, what does that actually mean? We don't really know. However, if this actually comes, that might be a really good thing, and they maybe will just be able to focus on this and actually bring this to the floor and actually maybe get something passed here for the American people going forward, especially as we know it's been getting to be a much more difficult time with all of these massive changes, closures, further restrictions, COVID just as a whole kind of running through the country right now. So hopefully, as we've talked about many times before, we can only hope right now that when Congress comes back, we can really give them some extra pressure and really focus on a $2,000 stimulus check because, as we know, with that $500 billion that's sitting on the books right now, peeling off $100 billion of that and sending it out to 50 million people, a $2,000 stimulus check, that would help out the lowest income and fixed income beneficiaries with a $2,000 stimulus check. For 50 million people, it would help significantly going forward, at least until they can figure out some kind of a long-term solution. So there's a lot going on right now, right? A lot has changed. And now that we're here, a couple weeks after they have left on their vacation, they may just come back and have a totally different attitude, especially after going back to their home districts and maybe getting an earful, hopefully, from people in their districts that have maybe talked to them, seen them out in public, maybe sent them messages on social media, who knows where, but hopefully people in their areas have given them an earful saying, hey, we're struggling, we need some support right now. So maybe they'll come back a little bit re-energized and with this whole idea of, hey, let's get some stimulus out to the people. One quick side note, remember early last year in 2021, President Biden was campaigning in early January in Georgia for the Senate runoff race. Do you remember that whole thing? And then he was really pushing for that $1,400 stimulus check at that time. Do you remember that whole thing? We were covering all the information back then. I don't remember the exact date. Maybe it was January 6th. It was that date kind of rings a bell as far as when he was doing that. But anyway, he was down in Georgia campaigning for those two senators. And he kept saying, if you give me those two senators, we'll get you a $1,400 check. Well, sure enough, the two senators came through because everybody in Georgia said, hey, I want $1,400. Yeah, we'll vote for it. So there you go. We got a bunch of votes out of Georgia. They got the two senators, and ultimately we got that $1,400 check. And that was just a year ago. That was just 1 year ago that was happening. So the president was out there campaigning for $1,400 checks. Remember that? Yeah, it was happening. It was a real thing. So you can feel free to look it up if you want. Otherwise, we covered it right here on the channel. Every single day we were covering that stuff very closely because we were right there in the thick of it. Well, it seemed like the thick of it, but realistically, we're really in the thick of it now. Now we're in the thick of it, right? We're like in the dense forest where you can't even see 2 feet in front of you because there's so much foliage, right? Yeah, that's kind of where we are now. So Anyway, I'll continue watching everything very closely. There's a lot going on right now, and when Congress returns back from their little vacation here, it's only going to get more intense. It's going to get way more busy. There's going to be a lot more things going on, and they're going to be trying to jam through some massive packages, the Build Back Better agenda, possibly another stimulus package that we've already heard about, possibly stimulus checks. There's a ton of stuff going on, and it's going to continue to get even more busy. So, hope this helps you out. Again, we're going to continue doing anything we possibly can to get through to Congress and remind them we need additional stimulus. We need money. We need some kind of relief. We don't really care what you call it. Just get us some money into our bank accounts as quickly as possible. So hope this helps you. Again, please make sure to hit that subscribe button right down below the video. Share this video with your friends, family, social media, and go back and check out any of the other 2,000 videos right here on the channel. And please remember, I'm here to help you out in any way that I possibly can. Leave your comments and questions down below, and I'll catch you again later in the next video. I'll see you for now, and enjoy the new year, and I'll see you in the next video.